Okay, the next method is called the fourth position. It's also called a linear interpolation method. It's another bracketing method. Okay, so it's actually the idea exactly is do the linear interpolation. You try to connect two points. You can consider your two estimations and the interval. You try to connect the interval endpoint and to find its intersection with the x axis. Okay, so the idea like this. Okay, the blue line, the blue curve is your function. Function fx. Okay, so there's the root. It's here. You see the intersection with the x-axis. So the root is here, and we want to give you the interval, the xl here and fr su here. We want to estimate the location of the root. Okay, so the idea is like this. We can find the function value fxl and fxu, and we do the linear interpolation like this. Actually, it's a straight line. You see, we form a straight line here, and the straight line is intersect with the x axis. We call it as hr. Okay, then the remainder is similar to a bisection. Then you, based on, you can estimate where is the root located. Is on this interval or this interval? Okay, so the idea is very similar to bisection, but the major difference is how to estimate the xr. In bisection method, we use the middle point, right? We use the middle point between xl and the xu. So the middle point will be here if you use the bisection. But use the fourth position, you actually do a linear interpolation. As a straight line intersect with the x axis, and xr is the intersection. Then you do the same thing as you do in bisection to shape which interval, the left part or the right part, contain the root. How to do the interpolation? Okay, it's just a very easy equation written as this. The idea is, actually, you see, it's a okay, from these few figures, you see there is two similar triangles. Okay, we use the property of similar triangles. Like this, you can see this one. It's a triangle, it's similar to this triangle. Right? Since they are similar, so we can use their ratio. Okay, so you can see you can see the ratio compared with this line and with this line. It's the same compared with this line to this line, right? Okay, we just form it and written as this. Okay, any problem?
After we want it. 就是用相似三角形的概念来去把这个写出来。
So here you can find two similar triangles here and here. So I just write it down. The distance from here to here, and also the SU minus SL from here to here. Okay, so means the distance of this line. So this line ratio is equal to what? So from here to here, right? So the F SU. And then here SU to SR. Okay. So you just know the SR to the left hand side and you can obtain this.
就是用简单的那种相似三角形的观念，等比例嘛，既然两个是相似三角形，那么就等比例，你就用这种比例的关系就可以把SR把它独立写在左手边，其他都写在右手边，你就可以得到这个公式了。这个就是我们算出SR的估计值，好，SR就在这个位置，就这个点。So this is the way we estimate SR. Okay, so the idea is also very simple. You can see the example 5.5. Where is it? On page 141. 在171页里面. Okay, the example 5.5 demonstrate the same case. The same case of the bungee jumper. Okay, but we just show it how fast compared with the bisection method. Okay, you see, if we use the force position method, the first iteration is your row bar, your SL is 50 and the SU is 200. And by using the above equation, you estimate the XR is 176. Okay. And then use the same method to check which interval, left interval or right interval, contain the root. Use the same method to do the detection. Okay, then you just keep. Okay, I keep this one. It's the left part, left interval, and we then use this interval again to estimate XR. Okay, so several iterations, you can see the result. Okay, the result is okay, you can see it's the relative error. It's about just two set iteration and your relative error is okay, it's 30%. 13% compared with the bisection. Okay? Compare with the bisection here. Okay, I think it's the right curve. 30%. Okay. problem, this example does not demonstrate the power of force iteration. Okay, but in general, the force transition is faster than bisection method. As you can see, usually this method can have a more close estimation to the root. Intuitive.
直觉上
force position 它可以比较估计到 更接近 root 的那个 xr 的值， 它会比 bisection 估得更准。 一般来说是这样， 那刚才特别举的例子， 它只有跑了两个 iteration， 然后就没办法显示它的效能。 所以就只是这样而已。 但是一般来说 force position 的效果是比较快的， 它比较快可以逼近 这个正确答案， 会比 bisection 来得好， 在实物上来说。 Okay. But this has its problem. Although in practice, the force position can converge faster than bisection. But there are some cases. There are some cases that will cause cause a slow convergence like this. For this case, you can see example 5.6. Force position often performs better, faster than bisection. Okay, here you see. There's the one important thing. Bisection does not take the shape into consideration. But for force position, it can be good or bad depending on the shape of function. For example, for this function, the function is x to the 10 minus 1. The function is like this. Here, you see the curve. Okay, for this function, if we use the bisection, use the force position, the result will be like this. Suppose your estimation from 0 to 1.2. Okay? For your interval, it's this. Your interpolation will be this point. And this point, you do the same thing. And your next estimation is here, and here. You see, their estimation to the root, if the step is very slow, very small, so that it converges, it will take maybe 10 or 20 iterations to be as close as to the correct answer root here. So the force position will be, its performance is dependent on the shape of the function. And in this case, it will perform bad. The convergence will be very slow. 好，这边就在说，这个 force position 啊，它有一个主要的问题，就是这个函数的形状啊，会影响它收敛的程度。好，比如说像这个。 像这个函数啊， 如果说你用 force position 的话， 你会发现你每次猜的 your estimation for fr 每次改进的幅度就是一点点一点点，它的确在收敛，但是幅度太小，这是它的问题。那如果 bisection 的话，它不会受到这个形状的影响，它每次就切一半，我就切一半，好，就切一半在这里，然后再切一半，一次就切一半，它很快就可以接近到这个真实的答案在这边。可是 force position 的话， 它会受限于这种特殊的形状，使得它每次的前进的这个步伐太小，就收敛很慢。好，所以 the main problem that's caused for such a special shape of the function is that its step, its convergence, is very slow. Okay, so it's the drawback of the force position. Otherwise, Otherwise, in practice, the fourth position open coupon space is converge faster. Okay, the special case we call the bad case for fourth position, we call it the one-sided. It means each time, when we estimate the root fr, then you have to decide which the left interval or right interval to be checked again. For one-sided means we always check left or we always check right interval. It's called a one-sided. In this case, just like this. You see? Each time when your estimation is here, you will check your root in the right path, right? In the right interval. Then you do the next estimation. Again you should check the right path. Okay, so each time your step is very small, and each time you find your root is located right, it's called a one-sided. So if you find your iteration has this phenomenon, you should maybe you should consider maybe you have dropped into the slow convergence like this case. Okay, so this will cause a poor convergence. Okay, especially particularly for the function with significant curvature. So maybe you can try to use some heuristic rules, use a heuristic way to remedy it. Okay. 你到底是有什么想法吗？ 好，那我这边再讲一下，就是这种所谓的 Y sizing， 也许你们可以想到一个方法，有一个自己的想法去解决这个问题，可以用一些比较经验的方法去解决这个问题。好，所以我在讲说，刚才少宇是有什么想到什么方法可以解决这个问题。好，那这个其实就是，你发现说你每次都在检查都是同一边的时候，因为我们也是 fourth position 也是找到一个点，然后切两半，然后你要检查说是左半边还是右半边。如果你发现你每次跑了好几次 iteration， 每次都检查右半边，每次都是只保留它的右半边，然后每次前进的步伐都很小，你就要考虑说你是不是就落入这种情况，收敛太慢的问题。一般来说，你的比较好的收敛应该要是一下子左边，一下跳右边，有时候跳左边，跳右边，这样会比较好。但是如果你发现它都一直都是往右边，或者都是一直在左边的话，那这样就其实不是一个好的现象。好，所以其实你可以去想一些比较简单的方法，比如说你发现都一直挑同一边，你可以保留一个记录，如果每次挑都挑同一边的话，那我是不是就应该要来做个例外，就是做对这种情况做个例外处理，改用，比如先用改用 bisection 来做，而不是用 post position 来做。好，所以这是一个可能的想法，那课本并没有给你这个答案，你们可以自己想一下。可以怎么样去设计去解决所谓的 one-sidedness 的问题。OK， so this slide shows a case study. It's called the case study is for the greenhouse gas and rainwater. OK, so I will skip it and leave it to you.